Hey, Pajama Grandma, here with Pajama Grandma's Chronic Painkillers Prescription. Today's prescription is all about feelings. And I say misty watercolored feelings, which probably dates me because that is the line from a song. But the whole topic of feelings, and I put little waves and pluses and minuses on the card today to remind me that this prescription is all about thinking about our feelings and realizing that we all have them. They're changing all the time. But the power and the trick in our feelings and our emotions is that we are in charge of them. We get to control them. We get to decide what we're going to think and feel and what our emotions are going to be. And I know you're probably saying, oh, Pajama Grandma, you are so full of nonsense. That turban on your head is too tight. I do not get to decide my feelings. I do not get to choose my feelings. Everybody around me flip-flaps and slaps me around and chooses my feelings for me because of the way they treat me. And I will say, absolutely, that is poppycock. Poppycock and nonsense and excuses for not taking personal responsibility for your own reaction to things. Now, do we all do that? Absolutely. Can my ex-husband still send me into a tizzy? I hate to admit it, but yes, he knows all of my exact buttons to push, and he knows what triggers to get me acting the way I don't necessarily want to act. We all have people like that in our lives. But it is always my choice to overreact. It is always my choice to let him upset me. It is always my choice to let other people upset me or not. And I'm choosing more and more as I get older and older to not let other people, things in the world that I can't control, nonsense around me, I don't let it affect me anymore. I just kind of create this big bubble around myself that I only let in the stuff that I want to experience. I just ignore the stuff or don't let it bother me, the stuff that I don't want to experience, the stuff I can't control. I cannot control what anyone else says to me or does around me. And a lot of the times it's none of my business. I can control my reaction to everything that happens to me, everything that happens around me. And part of controlling my reaction is choosing not to react, choosing not to let things bother me, choosing not to let things get to me. Now, I know this is a lot easier said than done, especially when we're experiencing chronic pain. When I'm having a really bad pain day, for example, yesterday morning, I was kind of grumpy and the kids were getting ready to go start their day and they noticed I was kind of quiet and just a little grumpier because I'm usually in a really awesome mood in the morning, but I had a migraine and I hadn't had enough quiet time in the morning yet to work myself through how I was feeling about that migraine. But I did. It only took me a couple of minutes, but it was still, the kids noticed that I was a little off. We all get that way. I'm not going to let you think that just because we have these awesome painkiller prescriptions at our fingertips means that we don't still have life experiences, because we certainly do. And thank goodness we do, because how boring would life be if things didn't change, if stuff didn't happen around us, if we didn't have things that we had the opportunity to react to. So I try to ask myself nowadays more often than not, what do I want to feel? How do I want my day to go? What would it take for me to feel the way I want to feel right now? And that's why you see me saying I'm awesome all the time. I used to say I'm fine, and then I saw a TED talk that was about the word fine, and I burst into tears because I realized that whenever I was telling other people that I was fine, I was lying to them because I didn't want people to know I was in chronic pain, and mostly I was lying to myself because when I was saying I was fine, I was barely making it. I was barely holding on by a skinny, skinny gray thread. It wasn't even a golden thread. It was a gray thread, and I have since pretty much taken fine out of my vocabulary, kind of like depression. Some things you got to take out of your vocabulary because you just don't want to feel them anymore. So fine and depression, those babies are out of here. They're gone. They're not in my life anymore. And that's why I say I am awesome so often, because I know if I say I'm awesome, that I am choosing to feel awesome. And pretty soon I do feel awesome. That's what I did yesterday to get out of my little bit of a starting funk. And that's what I do pretty much every day. So try that. Try this prescription today. Pick a feeling you want to feel and just decide to feel it. And don't wait to feel it. Don't wait 20 minutes to feel it, or however long sometimes we take. Just do it right now. You can do it instantly, like the snap of your fingers. That is today's painkillers prescription. Go out, make it an awesome day, and I will see you again soon with another chronic painkillers prescription. Bye.